In this video, we have to find on real x and y, satisfying x cube plus y cube is equal to 7 and x square plus y square plus x plus y plus xy is equal to 4. So we have x cube plus y cube and x square plus y square and x plus y and xy. So if we take x plus y is equal to alpha and xy is equal to beta, then x plus y whole square will be equal to alpha square, and it is x square plus y square plus 2xy, that is alpha square. So x square plus y square will be equal to alpha square minus 2xy, that is beta. And x plus y whole cube will be equal to alpha cube, and it is x cube plus y cube plus 3xy times x plus y, that is alpha cube, and x cube plus y cube plus 3 times xy is beta, and x plus y is alpha, that is alpha cube. So x cube plus y cube will be equal to alpha cube minus 3 alpha beta. And we have given that x cube plus y cube is equal to 7 and x cube plus y cube is alpha cube minus 3 alpha beta, that is 7. Suppose this is equation 1 and we have x square plus y square plus x plus y plus xy is equal to 4, and x square plus y square is alpha square minus 2 beta plus x plus y is alpha and xy is beta, that is 4, and it is alpha square, and minus 2 beta plus beta will be minus beta plus alpha is equal to 4. So beta will be equal to alpha square plus alpha minus 4. Suppose this is equation 2, and if we put the value of beta in equation 1, then we have alpha cube minus 3 alpha beta is equal to 7, and it is alpha cube minus 3 alpha, and beta is alpha square plus alpha minus 4, that is 7, and it is alpha cube minus 3 alpha cube minus 3 alpha square plus 12 alpha is equal to 7, and alpha cube minus 3 alpha cube will be minus 2 alpha cube minus 3 alpha square plus 12 alpha is equal to 7, and it is 2 alpha cube plus 3 alpha square minus 12 alpha plus 7 is equal to 0. And if we put alpha is equal to 1, then 2 plus 3 is 5, plus 7 is 12, minus 12 will be 0. That means alpha is equal to 1 is satisfying the equation. So alpha minus 1 will be a factor. So it is 2 alpha cube, and 3 alpha square can be written as minus 2 alpha square plus 5 alpha square, and minus 2 alpha will be minus 5 alpha minus 7 alpha plus 7 is equal to 0, and it is 2 alpha square times alpha minus 1 plus 5 alpha times alpha minus 1 minus 7 times alpha minus 1 is equal to 0. And we can take alpha minus 1 common, and we will get 2 alpha square plus 5 alpha minus 7, that is equal to 0. And it is alpha minus 1 times 2 alpha square, and 5 alpha is 7 alpha minus 2 alpha minus 7 is equal to 0. And it is alpha minus 1 times, here we can take alpha common, and we will get 2 alpha plus 7, and here we can take minus common, and we will get 2 alpha plus 7, that is equal to 0. And it is alpha minus 1 times alpha minus 1 times 2 alpha plus 7 is equal to 0. So alpha will be equal to 1, and alpha will be equal to minus 7 by 2, and beta is equal to alpha square plus alpha minus 4. So beta will be equal to 1 plus 1 minus 4, and beta will be 2 minus 4, that will be minus 2. And here also beta is equal to alpha square plus alpha minus 4, and beta will be equal to minus 7 by 2 square will be 49 by 4 minus 7 by 2 minus 4, and beta is equal to 4 will be LCM, and it is 49 minus 14 minus 16, and beta will be equal to 49 minus 30 will be 19 by 4. So here we get alpha is equal to 1 and beta is equal to minus 2, and here we get alpha is equal to minus 7 by 2 and beta is equal to 19 by 4. And alpha is equal to x plus y, that is 1, and beta is xy, that is minus 2. So the quadratic equation having root x and y will be t square minus sum of root, that is 1, times t plus product of root, that is minus 2, is equal to 0. The root of this equation will be x and y, and it is t square minus 2t plus t minus 2 is equal to 0, and we can take t common, and t minus 2 plus t minus 2 is equal to 0, and it is t plus 1 times t minus 2 is equal to 0. So we get t is equal to minus 1 and t is equal to 2. So x and y will be equal to minus 1 and 2, or 2 and minus 1. And here also alpha is x plus y, that is minus 7 by 2, and beta is xy, that is 19 by 4. So the quadratic equation having root x and y will be t square minus sum of root, that will be plus 7 by 2 times t, plus product of root, that will be plus 19 by 4, is equal to 0. The root of this equation will be x, and y. And if we multiply by 4, then we will get 4t square plus 14t plus 19 is equal to 0. And if we check d, then it will be equal to 14 square minus 4 times 4 times 19, and d is equal to 14 times 14 minus 4 times 4 is 16 times 19. So d is negative, that means it has no real root. So we get only two values for x and y. X and y is equal to 2 and minus 1, and minus 1